like it got a bit warmer.
That's because you're in Bellabog, the last bastion of humanity.
Last bastion?
Seven 700 years ago, monsters from beyond the sky set the world ablaze. The land was turned to scorched earth, with raging infernos and billowing towers of smoke stretching beyond the horizon. In the midst of the conflict, the eternal freeze descended without warning. Suddenly, sweeping winds brought blizzards which buried the invading legion. Bellabog was all that remained. The steadfast architects built this city. Under the protection of Klepoth, the Preservation, Bellabog remains forever warm in the face of unrelenting cold.
He's sure saying some weird stuff.
A marked change in tone. Sounds like he's quoting from a historical record.
Uh-huh. So why is he telling us all this?
He wanted to know.
We saw strange creatures outside the city. They must have come from a Terran corroded space. A fragmentum, correct?
How do you... That's right. Out there in the blizzard, there are still many threats, including the monsters you saw. The Silver Main guards are continuously engaged with the enemy, but I'm afraid the situation is bleak. After your meeting with the Supreme Guardian, I would like to consult you on this matter. We're lacking in intel.
We're here. This is Klepoth Fort, the heart of Bellabog and headquarters of the architects. The saviors of humanity. Long before the arrival of the Eternal Freeze, the architects braved the doubts and derision of the people, never wavering from their construction of its defenses. History has proven that their decision was the correct one. The architects named this fortress after Klepoth, Aeon of Preservation. Under their direction, humanity has withstood external enemy attacks and held off the Eternal Freeze. Even today, we resist the Fragmentum's corrosion. This fortress is also the residence of the Supreme Guardian.
The Supreme Guardian?
The leader of Bellabog, elected and appointed by the architects. The Supreme Guardians have watched over this city for generations, sheltering the people from harm. The current guardian is Madame Kokolia Rand. Every major strategic decision is issued by her.
Whoa, she sounds like a big deal.
I will now bring you to see Madame Kokolia. Please, have your words at the ready. Her time is precious, so she prefers concise communication.
We're gonna see her right now? Can I at least find a place to freshen up first?
Rest easy. The Madame Guardian doesn't care about formalities. Not to mention, you've only just arrived. It would be unexpected if you were familiar with Bellabog customs. I've dispatched a messenger to send word. Madame Kokolia will be aware of your arrival. Come with me.
But that's a meaningless sacrifice. How can you...
You may leave, Branya. Visitors have arrived.
Yes, Mother.
Madam Guardian, I have brought three outsiders to see you.
The messenger informed me. Well done, Jacquard. You may leave. Welcome, visitors from beyond the Eternal Freeze. Or perhaps I should say, from beyond the sky, no? I am Kokolia Rand, Bellabog's Supreme Guardian. I would be grateful if you could tell me why you have come. Do you wish me to doubt it? Or perhaps you're not confident in that identity yourself? No, I do not doubt it. I can see that you are not from this world. The architects remember the history well, else we should forget it. I know that in the distant past, before the Eternal Freeze descended or the Legion invaded, this world was once prosperous beyond measure. An eon connected our planet to other worlds, and we discovered the endless possibilities of the boundless universe. We also came to know of Klapoth, the Amber Lord. Under their attentive gaze, we built the city walls. So do not be surprised. For 700 years, the architects have received no further communication from the stars. But I knew of your existence. Tell me why you have come.
Do you think anyone's gonna know what you're talking about?
We came here for something known as a stellaron.
A stellaron?
Objects that fell from the blue on separate worlds. Their appearance spelled disaster. Many of the planets we visited have suffered their effects. You mentioned invasion by the Antimatter Legion. Soon after their arrival, this planet suffered the Eternal Freeze. At the same time, the phenomenon known as fragmentum space corrosion began to occur. Correct?
Correct.
Stellarons bring about different disasters on different worlds, but every world seeded with a stellaron will give birth to fragmentums. You can see us as kind-hearted, interstellar public servants, lending a helping hand to any world affected by a stellaron.
Your analysis of our current circumstances is clear. We have indeed suffered the disasters you speak of, some of which prove vexatious to us even today. But why should you care? Even if this stellaron you speak of did bring about disaster, I fail to see its connection to you. I don't believe that anyone would go to such lengths to help a world unrelated to them, unless they had something to gain.
You're right. Our reason for coming here is not purely selfless. If we don't seal the stellaron, we cannot leave this planet.
Yeah, FYI, we're pretty awesome.
You know how to seal the stellaron.
We have the relevant means.
Very well, I believe you. If our present situation is truly the result of this so-called stellaron, Then your arrival is the hope that Billabog has waited 700 years for. I am willing to assist you in any way possible to help you locate the Stellaron. It's getting late, and you must be tired. I will arrange for you to stay in our most comfortable hotel. Rest there and get a good night's sleep. Tomorrow at noon, I will dispatch someone to escort you here, and we can discuss this urgent matter in greater detail. It should be me thanking you, visitors from beyond the sky. I too need some time. I will go over our records for anything that may be connected to Stellarons. Please excuse me for not escorting you further. Of course, I understand. Do not worry. I have a way.
It seems that the Supreme Guardian holds you in high regard. I have received orders that your movements are no longer to be restricted.
You know, I didn't think things were gonna go that smoothly.
I'm afraid I still have duties to attend to. I must return to my post. I hope you enjoy your stay in Billabog.
Wait! Can you recommend some sites? It's not that late. We want to take a look around.
Well, I'd say that Golden Theater and the History Museum are both worth a look. However, you'd need a pass to get into the museum. I recommend you visit Everwinter Monument first. It's Billabog's most symbolic landmark. And if you enjoy music, you could head to Neverwinter Workshop. You can sometimes catch an outdoor performance there. The artist is... You'll see. Oh, and if you're staying at Goethe Hotel, please avoid the alley that runs next to it. The one with Silvermane Guard stationed there. It's started to be affected by corrosion recently, so it's been sealed off.
So the corrosion is inside the city. That's a grave situation.
Yes, we're mounting a resistance as we speak. I must leave now. I hope all goes well for you.
Do I have this already?
How incredible.
look at the carved ice! It feels perfect for this city somehow.
Whatever it's made of, it can't be ice.
I guess you're right. It's actually pretty warm in the city. Hey, what's with all the children over there? Should we go and take a look?
So let me introduce myself. I'm the intelligence officer for the Silvermane Guards, and a temporary guide for the A Journey Through Bellabog's History program. My name is Pelageya Sergeyevna, but you can call me Pela.
Yes, Miss Pela!
And perhaps the grown-ups among us could refrain from acting like children? Okay, guys, take a look over here. This is Everwinter Monument. It was erected to commemorate the mighty architects. The architects are followers of the Aeon Klopok. It was they that foresaw crisis, built up our walls, and established Bellabog, preserving the spark of human civilization. Even today, they are still tending to the city. Everwinter Monument is made up of two parts. A gear that symbolizes knowledge and industrial strength, and huge ice crystals that symbolize the eternal breeze. These two symbols are bound together, the gear restricting the ice. It represents the unyielding spirit of the architects in the face of nature's barbarity. Any questions? Any questions? The monument is made up of two parts. A gear that symbolizes knowledge and industrial strength, and huge ice crystals that symbolize the eternal freeze. These two symbols are bound together, the gear restricting the ice. It represents the unyielding spirit of the architects in the face of nature's barbarity. You mean, what are they made of? It's geomarrow that's undergone a change in color. The color of geomarrow is related to the environmental temperature during its refinement. The architects are followers of the Aeon Klopok. It was they that foresaw the crisis, built up our walls, and established Bellabog, preserving the spark of human civilization. Or, to put it another way, the architects are Bellabog's founders and saviors. Even today, they are still tending to the city. That's a question for the Scientific Research Division, though they may not be able to give you a definitive answer. The Eternal Freeze is no ordinary natural disaster. Meteorological records from hundreds of years ago cannot explain the cause. To put it simply, it's a problem that has plagued Bellabog scientists for centuries. And what about you guys? Take your time. We're not in a rush.
Here?
He said you can sometimes catch an outdoor performance. Sometimes being the operative word.
Oh, darn. I wanted to see one. Oh, I've been wondering. You see that heater over there? Why do they keep it outdoors? This city is so weird. Normally you'd want a heater inside a building, right? Maybe, but the ones outside just seem like a waste of energy. Oh, maybe this is how the architects repel the Eternal Freeze!
Tiny heaters are no use against the Stellaron disaster.
You guys sure have a lot to say about that broken heater.
Oh, wow, she's cool!
touch it and find out. Ice cold. I was just about to fix it up. I forgot to introduce myself. The name's Serval. I'm the owner of this workshop. If you got any broken equipment lying around, you can always come find me, though I can't guarantee I'll be interested in fixing it.
We're okay. I was just curious about the heater.
Curious? About the heater? It's just a standard geomarrow radiator. You can find them anywhere in the administrative district. Huh? What's wrong with that? Everyone around here knows the way I work. Ah! I figured it out! I heard a loudmouth guard say that a group of outsiders had met with Kokolia. You must be them? What an honor. Where are my manners? We can talk about heaters all day if you like. Let's have a chat.